You know what? This looks so bad. The entire Massey's test site just got wiped out. Yes, let's discuss the aftermath of Ship 36 explosion. Hey, I'm Lucas. Welcome to the SpaceX community. Let's get started. On the evening of June 18th, 2025, at approximately 11 p.m. Central Time, SpaceX's Starbase facility in Boca Chica, Texas, was the scene of a dramatic and unexpected event. Ship 36, a prototype of the Starship upper stage, was being prepared for a critical static fire test when it experienced a major anomaly, resulting in a massive explosion. The incident, captured in vivid detail by live camera feeds from LabPadre, sent a towering fireball into the night sky, with debris scattering across the Massey's testing center test site. This event marked another challenging moment in the development of Starship, SpaceX's ambitious project to create the most powerful and fully reusable rocket system ever built, designed to enable human missions to Mars, the Moon, and beyond. SpaceX promptly acknowledged the incident in an official statement posted on X, confirming that the anomaly occurred while Ship 36 was on a test stand at Starbase. The company emphasized that a safety clear area had been maintained throughout the operation, ensuring that all personnel were safe and accounted for. Additionally, SpaceX reported no hazards to residents in surrounding communities and requested that individuals refrain from approaching the area while safing operations were underway. These operations, conducted in collaboration with local officials, aimed to secure the test site and address potential risks such as leaking fuel or unstable structures. Local fire departments were dispatched to contain the fire, which continued to burn for several hours after the initial explosion, as shown in live feeds from The Verge. Static fire tests are a cornerstone of rocket development, allowing engineers to verify the performance of a rocket's engines and systems under controlled conditions. During these tests, the rocket is anchored to the ground, while its engines are briefly ignited, simulating the stresses of a launch without liftoff. For Ship 36, this test was a crucial step in preparing for Starship's 10th flight test, which would have advanced SpaceX's iterative development process. The anomaly occurred approximately 30 minutes after the propellant load sequence began, just before the static fire test was set to start. Video footage and eyewitness accounts described a sudden, intense burst of flame and smoke, with the rocket's nose section appearing to rupture before the entire structure was engulfed in flames. The explosion's force caused significant damage to the test stand and surrounding infrastructure, creating a crater-like depression and scattering debris across the site. The immediate aftermath saw SpaceX's Starbase team, in conjunction with local authorities, prioritize securing the site and ensuring public safety. The company's statement underscored that no injuries occurred, reflecting the effectiveness of Starbase's safety protocols. However, the damage to the Massey's testing center was substantial, with reports indicating that the site would require extensive cleanup and repair before resuming operations. I'd like to quickly remind you to subscribe to our channel if you haven't already. We regularly upload informative SpaceX and space news videos that you won't want to miss. Be sure to turn on the notification bell so you're notified whenever we release new content. The Starship program is central to SpaceX's vision of making humanity a multi-planetary species. The system comprises two main components: the Super Heavy booster, which provides the initial thrust for launch, and the Starship upper stage, designed to land on other planets and return to Earth. Both elements are intended to be fully reusable, a groundbreaking innovation that aims to drastically reduce the cost of space travel. SpaceX's ultimate goal is to use Starship for missions such as colonizing Mars, supporting NASA's Artemis program for lunar exploration, and enabling rapid point-to-point transportation on Earth. However, achieving these objectives requires overcoming significant technical challenges, as evidenced by the recurring issues with the ship prototypes. Previous Starship flight tests have also encountered setbacks, particularly with the upper stage. On Flight 7 and Flight 8, the ship experienced rapid unscheduled disassemblies, RUDs, less than 10 minutes after liftoff, a euphemism for catastrophic failures. Flight 9 saw the ship fly farther than ever before, but contact was lost approximately 46 minutes after launch, with its remains likely resting on the Indian Ocean seabed. In contrast, the Super Heavy booster has performed more reliably, with successful recoveries on Flight 7 and Flight 8 using the launch tower's chopstick arms. The Flight 7 booster was even reused on Flight 9, marking a significant milestone in reusability. These mixed results highlight the complexity of developing a spacecraft capable of surviving the extreme conditions of atmospheric re-entry and landing. The explosion of Ship 36 raises questions about the readiness of the current Starship design, particularly the V2 version being tested. SpaceX has been iterating on the design, with plans to introduce a V3 version capable of weekly launches within the next 12 months. Each anomaly provides valuable data to inform design improvements, but it also underscores the need for rigorous testing and safety protocols. The company's rapid iteration approach, while effective in programs like Falcon 9 and Dragon, means that failures are an expected part of the process. Elon Musk, SpaceX's CEO, has frequently acknowledged the challenges of Starship's development, emphasizing that rapid progress requires embracing the risk of failure. His vision for Starship remains ambitious, aiming to transform space exploration and enable human settlement on Mars. The immediate impact of the Ship 36 explosion is a likely delay in the schedule for Starship's 10th flight test. While SpaceX had not announced an official target date for Flight 10, the loss of Ship 36 necessitates building and testing a new upper stage prototype, a process that could take several weeks or months. The investigation into the cause of the anomaly, likely involving the U.S. Federal Aviation Administration FAA, will be critical for preventing similar incidents in the future. This investigation will analyze data from sensors on the test stand, review video footage, and examine recovered debris to pinpoint the failure's root cause. The findings may lead to modifications in the Starship design or testing procedures, further refining the system's reliability. The damage to the Massey's testing center adds another layer of complexity to the aftermath. The test stand and surrounding infrastructure will require significant repairs, potentially delaying other testing activities at Starbase. SpaceX's ability to restore the facility quickly will be crucial for maintaining the program's momentum. The company's track record of resilience suggests it is well equipped to handle these challenges, but the cumulative effect of multiple setbacks could strain resources and timelines. Beyond the technical and operational implications, the Ship 36 explosion has broader significance for SpaceX and the space industry. Starship is not just a rocket. It is a cornerstone of SpaceX's mission to make humanity a space-faring civilization. The program's success could revolutionize space exploration, enabling missions to the Moon, Mars, and beyond, while also opening new opportunities for commercial and scientific endeavors. NASA, for instance, has selected Starship as the human landing system for its Artemis program, aiming to return humans to the Moon by 2026. Delays in Starship's development could impact NASA's timeline, though contingency plans exist to mitigate such risks. Thanks for watching today's episode. Don't forget to subscribe and give us a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Stay tuned for another great video tomorrow.